It's Wednesday, 5th September, and this is Top Stories by Rooster News. Amazon.com on September 4th became the second US company to reach $1 trillion in stock market value, just weeks after Apple hit the same milestone on August 2nd. Shares in the world's largest online retailer last traded up 1.4% at $2,041.68. Its shares hit the 2050 level to give the stock a value of $1 trillion. Amazon has revolutionized how people shop online and is the world's dominant internet retailer. In two decades, the company expanded far beyond its bookseller beginnings, combining its world-spanning retail operation with less flashy but very profitable advertising and cloud computing businesses. The Seattle-based company has cemented customer loyalty through smart devices like Alexa and the Prime membership program that offers fast free shipping as well as music and video streaming perks. The state government, in a move to bring down accidents, will be launching the Automatic Fining System, or AFS, on GST Road in Chennai, said Transport Minister M.R. Vijay Bhaskar. The system will monitor lane discipline and rash driving. At an awards distribution function organized by the MTC in the city yesterday, Mr. Vijay Bhaskar said, "With the development of good highways and the availability of high-speed vehicles, accidents in the state had gone up. Tamil Nadu now ranks second in the number of accidents in the country. In this light, the government has decided to go in for AFS technology," he added. Mr. Vijay Bhaskar said that the AFS will be launched from Chengalpattu to Tiruchi over the length of 280 km in the first phase, with the entire highway network in the state to be covered in phases subsequently. He said the government had allotted Rs 25 crore for bringing the AFS technology to state highways. IT would monitor traffic violations through sophisticated CCTV cameras installed at various points and automatically generate fines and suspension of licenses. As part of the Neyveli Lignite Corporation India Limited's commitment to produce 4,251 megawatts through solar and wind energy, the company has installed solar panels on terraces of its seven office buildings at the cost of Rs 5.49 crore. NLCIL has already commissioned 491 megawatts through green energy units installed at Tirunelveli and Virudhunagar districts besides Neyveli. The project, under various stages of progress in Tirunelveli, Virudhunagar and Ramanathapuram districts, will produce over 900 megawatts using solar power. The utility has planned to install solar panels at the general hospital and schools with the aim to produce 4 megawatts of power. Discussions are on with Karnataka, Odisha, Madhya Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh and the Indian Railways to install panels with the aim to generate 2,850 megawatts of solar power. At least 200 of 221 students admitted to the three-year LLB honours course in Tamil Nadu's Dr. Ambedkar Law University under the NRI quota between 2014 and 2017 had not submitted basic documents essential for admission, an investigation has revealed. Rules mandated that candidates seeking admission under the NRI quota must submit 27 documents. This includes NRI status certificate issued by the Indian Embassy of the respective country where the person sponsoring the student is a resident. The fees in US dollars should be paid from the account of the sponsoring person. In more than 200 cases, we found that there were violations, a senior investigator told reporters. The DVAC has registered a case against six persons, including Vice Chancellor P. Vananga Mudi, Registrar in Charge V. Balaji, Professor and Head of Department and Director Distance Education K. S. Sarwani, amongst others. Mr. Vananga Mudi was accused of amassing huge wealth by corrupt and fraudulent means. It was also alleged that fake visas and other documents were created to facilitate admissions under the 15% NRI quota. On the basis of preliminary inquiries, the agency said it appeared that the accused officials conspired to forge documents to make it appear as if the students were NRIs, thereby cheating the university. Afghan Defense Ministry spokesman Mohammad Radmanish said Jalaluddin Haqqani's death was not expected to mean any major change for the Haqqani network. Operationally, his death will not have an impact on the group, he said, adding that Haqqani's role in recent years was ideological rather than practical. Jalaluddin, whose network is known for its heavy use of suicide bombers against Afghan civilians, security forces, and US-led NATO troops, was a key figure in entrenching jihad in the conflict-ridden region over the past 40 years. His group is at the heart of regional tensions, with Washington and Kabul long suspecting the Haqqanis of having links to Pakistan's shadowy military establishment. But after the US invasion of Afghanistan in 2001 toppled the regime, Jalaluddin pulled back from the public eye, making only a handful of appearances in the later years as the fearsome reputation of the Haqqani network began to grow. He had been bedridden for years and had already passed the leadership to his son Sirajuddin, who is also the Taliban's deputy leader. Jalaluddin was from among the great distinguished jihadi personalities of this era, the Taliban said in a statement posted on Twitter. We round up this newscast with fuel prices from key metros. In Delhi, petrol is sold for 79.40 rupees per litre and diesel for 71.43 rupees per litre. In Chennai, petrol is sold for 82.51 rupees per litre and diesel for 75.48 rupees per litre. In Kolkata, petrol is sold for 82.31 rupees per litre and diesel for 74.27 rupees per litre. In Mumbai, petrol is sold for 86.80 rupees per litre and diesel for 75.82 rupees per litre.